school is a cheerleader. Woo!
Cheerleading since 1898 has been consumed by the stereotype of pom-poms, short skirts and football chants. However, in modern cheerleading, this is simply not the case.
I think cheerleading is a really good thing. I think it encourages people to do something a bit different, because in England specifically, you don't hear a lot about cheerleading. It's mainly something that is considered like an American high school kind of thing. And in England, and in quite a lot of other countries, I don't think people really appreciate it as much. They don't appreciate how much effort actually goes into it and all the rehearsals and the strain that it can have on your body as well. It's all about, like, your body becomes like an athlete. You have to train and keep yourself flexible, so I think it's good.
It's very American-based. It's not popularised over here enough.
I think because cheerleading's not in the media often enough, it's not fair to give an honest opinion of it, because all you see of it is like American films and like the blonde athletic hot girls of the school doing it, when in reality I don't think it's like that.
I think it's an interesting activity to get involved in, but I don't think personally I would do it. But I like watching loads of cheerleading films and things like that too.
Modern all-star cheerleading consists of numerous elements which combine together to create a four-minute routine. These consist of dance, jumps, stunts, pyramids and gymnastics, which are then performed in front of a panel of judges as well as a 2,000-strong audience across the country. These performances range in levels starting from 1 all the way up to 6. It's stereotypical that squads only consist of females and that it's unusual to find a male cheerleader. In fact, the act of cheerleading itself was created by a male Princeton graduate called Thomas Peebles, who introduced the idea of crowds cheering at football games. It is since then that cheerleading has evolved into the sport of hard work, dedication and determination.
I think it shows because of the movies, and it's very stereotypical when people say, give me an A, give me a B. They don't realise how much hard work you put into it. They think it's all just like jumping around on pom-poms, and it's not. It's actually hard work and dedication.
When most people are asked about cheerleading, they immediately think of America, linking the activity to varsity events, blonde girls with short skirts and loud repetitive chants. This image is particularly due to the American culture and its media products, such as the films High School Musical and Bring It On, as well as TV shows Hellcats and Glee. In all of these examples, the representation of cheerleaders is misleading, which has caused the British audience to make stereotypes. In reality, the main event for British Cheerleader is preparing a routine to show a regional, national or international competition. British cheerleaders are of all shapes, sizes, heights, ethnicities and backgrounds, with most squads calling themselves a family. With regards to the scantily clad uniforms, teams will be disqualified if any member is thought to be wearing a revealing outfit, all of which completely disregards the suspected stereotypes.
Cheesy smiles.
A sport. Dedication.
Prepping girls in your short skirts and blue jeans.
Pom-poms. Inspirational.
Amongst the cheer world, many fear that cheerleading should be labelled a sport. Cheerleaders learn and own the same skills that an athlete or footballer would have. Strength, stamina, determination and passion, just to name a few. Cheerleaders are dedicated to their teams, attending weekly training sessions of more than 6 hours. During practice, they can endure numerous injuries, some of which can be fatal. The Journal of Paediatrics claimed that over 25,000 cheerleaders were in the emergency room in 2007, a statistic which has doubled due to the sport's increasing popularity.
I would say yeah, because it's a good way to keep fit, like it's a fitness activity, but I wouldn't expect people to be like, oh yeah, that's what I do as a sport.
Yeah, cheerleading should be considered a sport because it's like dancing, and you have to train yourself. You have to limber, you have to become flexible, and you have to practice. It's not something that's just easy. It's not just running around and smiling and waving your pom-poms. You actually have to try and train, just like running. Before you do performance, you have to rehearse and put a lot of time and energy into it to look good.
Yeah, because it's competitive. You win something at the end of it, so it's like any other sport.
There's a cheerleader that I know who recently suffered some injuries, and I think a sport would strain you to the point where you would injure yourself, so it should be classified as a sport.
This whole documentary has been about cheerleading and other people's perceptions of it, but I thought I'd give a personal account as to what I think cheerleading is. I'm a cheerleader myself. I've been cheerleading for about 5 years now, and it is competitive all-star cheerleading, which means we do go to competitions and we do compete against other people.
As a parent, it's quite a concern. She's a flyer because she's the lightest member of the team, which means she gets thrown about a lot. So as a mum, it's quite a worry that every time she goes, I'm worried that she doesn't hurt herself. When she goes into competitions and she's away from home, I worry that she's going to come back uninjured and okay. But she loves it.
Altogether with cheer, I've had quite a few serious injuries. I'm currently out of cheerleading because I've injured my back to the point where I've had to go to hospital. I've had cracked ribs, I've had a broken nose, I've had nosebleeds, bruises, swollen eyes, everything you can think of. The point of this documentary is to kind of show people that cheerleading is not just about pom-poms. It does actually involve quite a few other things that are a sport, and I don't really know many sports that would injure someone to the point where they have to visit hospital.